government going too far to keep us safe? That's the question facing Americans as new reports reveal the scope of the government's access to our lives online and also on the phone.
Yeah, Hallie Jackson is in our Washington, D.C. bureau tonight with the first remarks the president has made about this controversy.
Matt and Wendy, critics say the surveillance goes too far, but President Obama argues these, what he calls, modest measures are the price we pay for safety.
I'm going to take one question.
He actually took two, and for 14 minutes, President Obama defended his administration's surveillance techniques.
You can't have 100% security and also then have 100% privacy.
The Director of National Intelligence has declassified information about a program that pulls what's called metadata from phone companies.
Nobody is listening to your telephone calls.
But the National Security Agency is collecting information from potentially millions of Americans, like who you called, when you called, and how long you talked. President Obama says a different internet spy program targets only foreigners. Several newspapers report the PRISM program accesses things like emails, chats, and photos from 9 U.S. tech companies, including Google and Facebook, which say they're only doing what's required by law.
We just have really no way to kind of understand the effectiveness of these programs.
Privacy advocates worry some of this surveillance may not be legal.
The fact that they have access, the lack of transparency and oversight should raise a lot of red flags here.
But Congress has approved these programs for years, beginning in 2006 under President George W. Bush.
It's kind of a terrifying thought to think that two presidents from such completely different ideologies are engaging in such similar practices. It suggests one possibility is that they cease classified information that should have all of us worried.
Kentucky Senator Rand Paul introduced a bill today to require government agencies to get a warrant before searching the phone records of Americans. In Washington, I'm Hallie Jackson, Channel 4 Action News.